Hey guys, this is Aaron. Today I want to take a look at three mini extensions. These are simple utilities that run off of a single button click, little to no setup or preferences or anything like that. The first one I want to look at is Weld. So what Weld does is takes a bunch of separate pieces, like this line here. You can see I have a bunch of arcs and lines together creating a path. I do this a lot if I'm going to do a follow me or something like that. It'll take all these pieces, and with a button click right here on the Weld icon, if I click that, it's going to turn it into a single line. If I pick on it, you can see up in empty info, it tells me it is now a curve. So that's all one piece. I can move it together. I don't have to worry about pieces getting disconnected if I move or something like that. This is also useful with circles. Now, when circles are first drawn, they're drawn as a single line that's filled in with a surface. But what can happen because of intersecting geometry or because of I might explode the curve, I end up with a bunch of segments. Not a big deal with Weld. What I can do is select all these lines and the surface, click on Weld, and I'm back to a single circle again. Again, it does call it a curve. It's not a circle at this point, but it is put together. So if I do something like push-pull it, I will get a nice smooth surface rather than a bunch of separate pieces that the broken segments would have created. The next utility I want to look at is called Pushline. Pushline is a great utility. It creates a push-pull-like command for lines, just like the name says. So if I go into Pushline, Pushline is available through the extension warehouse from Dennis B. I can click on a line and pull it, and what it will give me is a surface. So it's a great utility, especially if you start with single dimension, something like that, that you need to end up pulling into a surface, something like this, like I'm doing here. It's a great way to do it. It works just like push-pull, but works with lines. An excellent tool, real quick and easy to use. There is no learning curve, and a nice mini extension, worth checking out. The last one I want to look at is Solar North. Solar North is available from the SketchUp team, also on the extension warehouse. I'll put links to all of these extensions in the description below. Solar North is real simple. When you first model something in SketchUp, the assumption is that the green line is running north. So when I look at something like my shadow settings, as I'm moving these around, that is all based on the green line running to the north. Of course, this changes a little bit if I geolocate, that sort of thing. But generally speaking, if I just start modeling, it's looking up here as being north. Now, Solar North does a couple things. There's actually more than one button, but it's pretty much that simple. First thing is, if I turn on this toggle, it will show me where north is for this model right now. So you can see it's actually just off axis. The other thing I can do is I can actually come in here and I can click to change north. So this will let me click on a point, in this case I chose the origin, and drag back and forth to change which direction is north. This is great if you have, if you get a model from someone else and you don't know which direction is north in their model. Toggling the orange line, I will show you where north is. Or if you're modeling something and you've modeled incorrect, don't want to go rotate, don't want to do that sort of thing, you can actually just come in here and pivot north rather than having to change your model or reset anything. So that's Solar North from the SketchUp team. Again, we looked at Weld, Pushline, and Solar North, all available on the extension warehouse. Those are our three mini extensions. Thank you.